So for today, or actually this week, we have something of a celebration. So this week is our 300th episode of Everyday Grammar, our 300th Everyday Grammar program. And so the idea for this week's report is to explore some phrasal verbs that go into the writing of all of these Everyday Grammar reports. And luckily, this vocabulary does not just connect with everyday grammar programs, it connects with any kind of problem-solving activity that you might do. So for example, earlier, just a few minutes ago, when I had difficulties logging on, I had to do a little bit of problem-solving. And some of the vocabulary that you will learn about today connects with what I had to do just a few minutes ago. So you will be able to use this vocabulary that we discuss and your grammar understanding of it moving forward whenever you discuss any kind of problem-solving activity. Okay, so to start with, I'd like to open our talk with the term phrasal verbs. Are any of you familiar with the term phrasal verb? And if so, what is it?
Yes. Phrasal verbs, it's a term that we usually use in grammar. Actually, it is a verb with a preposition that we always use. For example, we say turn on the light, or you can say turn off, or other phrasal verbs that we have.
Yes, that is excellent. That is a perfect definition. And I don't know if all of you heard, but when people were introducing themselves, one of the viewers used the term stands for. So Nepal stands for never-ending peace and love. So in this case, stands for is a phrasal verb. So a phrasal verb consists of a verb, which you might recognize, and then another short word or words. Sometimes it might have two short words. So for example, the phrasal verb look up to. So for example, I look up to Greg. It means I think highly of Greg as a role model, right? And so you might look up to your parents or look up to your teachers. But the phrasal verbs that we will discuss today involve a verb and another short word. Okay, so they're typically two word structures, and together, when you put this verb and short word together, they take on a meaning that is different from what the individual words suggest. So these can be difficult because sometimes if you look at a verb, you see a verb and you understand, you know what that verb means, but then you're not quite sure what happens, how the meaning changes when we have that other short word with it. Okay. So we'll explore ways you can figure out the meaning of phrasal verbs, even if you don't know what they mean. Okay, so just to reiterate, as Shah Muhammad described, phrasal verb is a idiomatic structure with a verb and another short word. So for example, we might have the phrasal verb go on. So if you've followed, news reports, you might ask the question, what is going on in the United States? Or what is going on in Afghanistan, for example? Can anyone guess, based on the context that I've given you, what do I mean when I say go on, going on?
I mean, it's mean continue, right?
Go on, it can mean continue. It can mean continue, but if I asked you what is going on in your country, if you didn't know what going on means, what how would you guess? So I'm saying, what is blank in your country?
Is it like happening in your
country? Exactly. So what is happening in your country? So for example, if you read the news, you might go to VOA Learning English and ask yourself, what is happening in the United States, or what is going on in the United States? So this is an important idea, you're always going to meet new phrasal verbs that you don't know or understand. But if you can recognize that a phrasal verb has a verb and then another short word with it, if you recognize that that is a phrasal verb, there is often another word you can kind of guess the meaning. Okay, so this is the big idea I would like to draw your attention to for today. I'll teach you some phrasal verbs, but just so you know, there are ways you can figure out the rough meaning of a statement, even if you don't know what a phrasal verb means, okay? So the important idea is to look at the context of the sentence if you don't know a vocabulary word or words. So to start out, so the idea for this week's report was to go through four different phrasal verbs that relate to the writing of every everyday grammar report. And coincidentally, all of these phrasal verbs can be used to talk about any kind of problem solving. So the first step that we do whenever we write an everyday grammar program is to figure out what the topic will be. Figure out, it means to try to come to an understanding or to understand something. So for example, at the very beginning of today, when we first met, when I was late arriving, I had some technical difficulty. I was not able to log into the meeting. So when I had this problem, I had to figure out what was going on. And you are correct. It's to try to come to an understanding of the problem. Okay. And so, for example, when we discuss everyday grammar programs in our meetings, one person might ask the other, have you figured out an everyday grammar topic for next week? So in this case, it means kind of come to an understanding, but it also can mean to decide something. So it has both of these meanings, okay? So it can be come to an understanding or decide. It can kind of carry both of these senses. Can anyone think of any other situations or examples where they might use the phrasal verb figure out?
David, go ahead. And Binod, I don't know if you were trying to answer, but your microphone wasn't on. But David, why don't you go ahead first?
For example, in mathematics, we can use this to figure out. For example, there's a math problem. You can say how we can figure out this math problem.
Great, yes. That is a great example. I'm not sure who said that, but great example. Other examples? Alita?
Yes, for example, when I'm studying a new topic in Italian and the teacher is explaining something and I try to figure out that topic.
Yeah, I'm sure with any new language, we're all trying to figure out, you know, what people are saying. Muhammad.
When my mom was mad at me, I tried to figure out what's happening.
Oh yeah, figure out someone's emotions, like figuring out their body language. That's a good example as well. David, did you have an example?
Yes, I have one. For example, we couldn't figure out where all my money had gone.
Yeah, figuring out finances. I think most of us do that quite frequently, at least I do. Tron, do you have an example?
I think it's when I was studying in my English class. My teachers were give me an example about any topic, and I try to...
Oh, yes. Finish the sentence. So I try to...
Yes. Yes. I try to guess what that means.
Yes. Guess or figure it out. Okay. So that would be using the phrasal verb. But great example. I think we had someone else with their hand up. I think it was, oh, Benoit, would you like to say something?
Okay, I'm going to figure out grammar problem with this BUA program.
Yes, right now we're figuring this out all together. So,
yes. And if I could jump in, so all of you have been giving excellent examples. So for example, a lot of you use the structure, I will try to figure out, okay? Or we had one person use could, I could not figure out. But just so that you know, you can figure out in terms of talking about the future or the past as well. So for example, if you're traveling, you might say, I will arrive in London next week. I will figure out where I will stay when I arrive. Okay, so you can use figure out in terms of the future as well. Uh-huh. Okay, just so you know.
Okay, and when I see a philosophical issue, I always want to figure out what's its meaning, like cosmology, and I do like that, and I always want to figure out what is that or what that topic is about, because I'm interested in it.
Yeah, figuring out new things, something I think we all do each day. And the username starts with a phone number. Can you remind me your name?
Just call me Henry. Okay, that is my nickname, Henry.
Okay, write it down.
And I'm from Vietnam. Right, so I'm gonna give the example for the word to figure out. As we know, in this pandemic, that is for coronavirus, so the scientists are figuring out the vaccine to solve the problem here. So we can use the word figure out. Yes, that's in my example.
Yes, large. We can figure out large things like the vaccine or even climate change. So figuring out climate change, that might be another scientific larger example.
Yes, and if I might jump in here, this point that Henry just raised leads nicely into a second phrasal verb that is useful for discussing the coronavirus pandemic, and it also relates to when we write everyday grammar reports. So the first step is we need to figure out a topic, figure out what is going on. The second step is we need to work out a way to deal with the problem. So for the example Henry gave, he said scientists are trying to figure out what is going on with the coronavirus pandemic. Then from that, we might say public health officials are working out ways to stop the pandemic, or scientists are working out ways to deal with the public health crisis. So I use the phrasal verb work out, which you may have heard before. What do I mean by work out in this situation?
Oh, I see. I got it. Thank you.
Can anyone give an example of or a definition for the phrasal verb work out? And do you think you could give an example?
So about the meaning of the work out, like you find a way to resolve the issue. So it means work out, is right?
Yes, yeah. Do you want to use an example sentence?
Okay, so I will have an example about the work out. My mobile phone were turned off suddenly yesterday, and then I work out that it's run out of battery. So I just reach out it.
Yeah.
In this case, you gave an excellent example. So you could use figure out. So your iPhone wasn't working. So you figured out that you started to understand that your iPhone ran out of battery. So once you figured out that your iPhone was out of battery, you worked out a way to charge it. In other words, you worked out a way to bring the battery back to life. So we have figure out, which is kind of to understand or to decide, and work out means to kind of is more related to taking an action. You're thinking carefully, but you're more taking an action or doing something carefully. Does that make sense?
Yes, makes sense. But I have a question that is quite confused between figure out and work out, right? Because like it's the same meaning that you find a way to resolve the problem. Like for figure out that you see something problem there and you try to find a way what happened with this. And then it's work out, that's the same, it's quite the same meaning. Like you see the problem and you do something to resolve it.
Yes, they are very connected, but if I used a different term, so the figure out is the understanding part. Work out means doing, it's more related to doing an action once you have understanding. So you work out a plan. So once you understand, so for example, a math problem, you might figure out the size of a problem. Then you work out a plan to deal with the problem. So for example, are any of you familiar with, for example, a sport, rock climbing, a sport that was just included in the Olympics in Tokyo, rock climbing, okay? So in rock climbing, they have what are called problems. So when rock climbers, when they do a rock climbing problem, they figure out the size of the problem. So they figure out how high they have to go, figure out how far they can reach to the left and how far they can reach to the right. Once they have figured out the scope, the size of the problem, that means understand, then they work out a plan or they work out a way to climb up. So they are very closely related, okay, figure out and work out. But there is a small difference wherein figure out is more completely understanding and then work out can involve some kind of action. It is action with understanding. So oh, they yeah. are very they are very close.
Yeah,
very,
I got
very
it.
Very close, but there is a small difference. So when we say, for example, in the coronavirus pandemic, scientists are figuring out the size of the problem. You know, once they have figured out the size of the problem, then they work out ways to deal with the problem. And each of those ways might be, for example, you know, vaccines and masks and so on, you know. So that's they are close, but there's a small difference there.
We have some more hands up. Tron, do you want to give an example with work out?
I think is when my class is, my teacher is asked to give me some homework. We need to work out to find the answer of the homework.
Exactly. That is a great example. Well done. Thank you.
And just one point. So we often will often use the phrasal verb work out with the noun or noun phrase. So we often say work out along with work out a way or work out a plan as well. So just so you know, this phrasal verb often goes with a noun or with a noun phrase after it. So we often say work out a plan, work out a way to do something. And just to be clear, we're not talking about workout. Okay, so just to be clear, can all of you hear when I speak the difference? So we have workout and work out. Okay, so we're talking about work out, the phrasal verb. We're not talking about workout. Okay. Can anyone tell me? Can anyone tell me the difference of what I just in what I just said?
So workout is like a gym thing, and workout is phrasal verb.
Exactly. Yes. So that. Yeah, so that's one difference in the pronunciation. And you can also tell from the context. So for example, if Greg said, I'm going to the gym to work out, you know from the situation, he's not talking about figuring out a way to do something. You know, he's talking more like doing exercises, you know, getting strong, all that kind of stuff. Next two I had planned for the report, we have go ahead. Okay, so once you've figured out the size of a problem, once you have worked out a way to deal with the problem, you can go ahead and do something about the problem. In this case, go ahead, it means you carry out an action. Okay, so we have and so for example, when we write our everyday grammar reports, when we discuss ideas, we might say, have you figured out a topic for next week? Yes. Have you worked out a way to include fun audio examples or movie examples? And then one person might say to the other, oh, you should go ahead with that story. And that means to carry out an action, to write it and put it on the website, okay? All right, and so could we just have maybe one or two examples of go ahead, just to make sure that you guys understand?
I think we can use go ahead in different ways. For example, when you're, as John Russell said, when you're writing something, you can use this phrasal verb, for example, go ahead with this term, or go ahead with this term. We can use this in other places as well. For example, when somebody is going somewhere and asking you about the direction, you can say, for example, take left and go ahead, or other examples of things.
Yes, so there is another context. So with directions, going ahead means to go straight or to keep following a path.
Go ahead means a kind of approval to carry out some work. Say, we work out to find the solution for our organizations. Is that correct? It's approval. Go ahead means we can carry on.
Oh, yes, exactly. You asked for the go ahead. Yeah, exactly. So you can, you know, ask for an approval to carry out an action. And, you know, and to give you another example, perhaps using the past tense. So I may say, for example, I might talk about a family member, perhaps my mother. I might be talking about what my mother did. And I'll say, oh, she went ahead and bought a new car. That means she carried out the action. She you know, carried out the action of buying a new car. Okay, and so I might just go to our final phrasal verb, and then we can perhaps, you know, discuss a bit more. The final phrasal verb is to look back. So in our everyday grammar reports, we figure out a topic. We work out a way to explore the topic. We go ahead with the story. Then we look back at what we have done. So that involves looking at the comments from readers such as yourselves, or reading through our report again and thinking about the strengths and weaknesses of the report. So in this sense, does anyone have an idea what we mean by look back? Okay.
Okay, look back means thinking about the past, our life or past friends, just thinking the past, not the present. That's it.
Yes, exactly. And so if you look at the individual words, you might think that, so for example, I look back. It doesn't mean that directly, but it's absolutely correct. When you look back, it means to reflect or think about the past or what you have done. So for example, you might speak to your grandparents or someone who is older in life, and they might say, oh, looking back on my life, I was happy I did this. Or looking back at my life, I wish I had done this, in other words. So they're passing on some kind of wisdom. But when you look back, it implies some kind of reflection or thinking about what is behind you. And can anyone give some other examples?
Tron had his hand up. Would you like to give an example?
Oh, yes. Like my dad, go ahead for me to use the computers to join TALK2US.
Okay.
Good. So we can say dad told me to go ahead and join TALK2US, or my dad gave me, as a noun, you could say my dad gave me the go ahead to join TALK2US. In this case, I used it as a noun. And then at the end of this, you might say, oh, looking back at my TALK2US experience, I'm glad my dad let me go ahead and join the program.
Oh, I understand.
Muhammad, would you like to give an example?
This is for the back. When my mom is still mad at me, I think I need to look back what I've done in the past.
Do we have other examples? Sorry, we're both kind of like, yeah, let's not maybe look back right now, but. that is a good example. Thank you, Mohammed. It's good to reflect on maybe if we did something wrong so we can learn and do something better next time. So it can be good to look back. Do we have other examples?
Yeah, for example, yesterday when I was talking to my brother, we were looking back about the last year when we started this pandemic, and we're trying to figure out and work out as well to this situation.
Yeah, I sometimes do not want to look back and, you know, think of the past year, maybe avoid it, but that's okay.
So when you look back on the past year, have you figured out some things in your life that you would like to change? Or when you look back on the past year, can you figure out things that you have done that you enjoyed or that you liked?
Exactly.
There's some positive things there too. Henry, would you like to give an example?
Yes. Hi, everyone. When I look back on my childhood, I can distinctly remember many memorable moments that I shared with my family during our holidays in the summertime. Yes, that's my example.
Yes, sometimes it's nice to look back and think of the fun things we did with our family when we were kids in the summer. I do too. It's nice to think back on those things. Do we have some other examples?
I just look back the time when I was in Australia. Yeah, I really remember the time that I can traveling. I could travel.
Yes, I think we all have been looking back and thinking of the different things that we did, like traveling and wanting to do that, but that's okay. We will look back in the future. I will look back in a few years and think, you know, we did it and that's what we needed to do.
Okay, so in the city area, we can see the space is available. So they want to hire that space. So they say too late, but we are talking about the phrasal verbs. It starts from verb, then to. But too late means, can we use it as a phrasal verb or not?
I think so. To let, we would say to rent in the States. So it's like to lease, right? Where you're paying someone who owns the building.
Okay.
So you can say we would say to rent. So to rent out. So that would be a phrasal verb. Or to let out. That would be, I think, the British way of saying it. And John, do you want to agree with me on this one? So just so I have my American versus British English correct.
Yes, and so if you say to rent would be just the infinitive of it. Rent is a verb. To rent would be the infinitive, as in I want to rent my house or something like that. Or I have to, I rent, I don't know how to give an example here, just a second. My mom wants to rent her house or something like that, or she has to rent her house. But when we say rent out, then it becomes a phrasal verb because it has the rent and then out, okay? So so for example, Greg might say, imagine Greg is a real estate mogul, he owns lots of properties. He says, oh, I rent out all of my properties, or I rent out many properties. That would be an example of a phrasal verb of it.
Yeah, and there's two different meanings there. So if I were to rent, it means I'm paying money. But if I were to rent out, it means someone will be paying me. So it does change the meaning there. But we have some more hands up. So thank you for that question, though. I think that was a good opportunity to look at the difference between American and British English. So thank you.
Yep. Thanks for the opportunity. I want to give an example of figure out. Can I say I've figured out that I'm on my eighth semester right now. So without wasting time, I go ahead to my thesis. Is that right?
So you said you figured out that you're in your what?
I'm on my eighth semester.
Your last year.
My last year.
Your last year. Yeah. I think it might be clearer to say I realized. I think that might be more clear. I think someone would understand you, but I think we'd be more comfortable with realized or remembered.
Thanks, Greg.
Yeah.
So welcome. For example, you might say, I realized that I am in my eighth semester and I have not yet figured out what I will write for my thesis. Something like that. Yeah.
That's right.
And hopefully you will work that out.
Thanks, Greg.
You're welcome.
That's a good.
And don't delay. Go ahead and write it.
Yes.
And then you won't have to look back and think of the mess. Sorry. Okay.
Hard to look back what I've done to my mom.
Yeah. But thank you, everyone. Why don't we say thank you to John Russell. If you'd like to stick back or stay on the call, we can answer some questions or have a quick conversation. But otherwise, let's thank John for joining us today.
Thanks, John. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.